So in the previous video, we just looked at these associative and commutative properties, but let's just define them properly. And if we define them properly, we can use them in future proof. So the first type of binary operation we're just going to talk about, let's get a new pen. The first one we're going to talk about is just this commutative property. So let's have a look. Commutative, there we go. This commutative type of binary operation. And what we're going to define that is on some set. Let's define this. First, let's have our binary operator. Our binary operator. And let's make that just this generic symbol, just our little circle. So we have our binary operator. We have the set on which we're going to it's going to apply to elements, this operation on elements of the set. And let's have this set X, and let's have two elements of that set. We're going to have some elements of that set, elements, and let's make it X1 and X2, and they are all both elements of the set. And we say that this operation, this binary operation on the elements of the set, is commutative. We as human beings define it. That is our choice. This is how we define it. If the following property holds, if I have x1, the binary operation on x2, that equals x2, binary operation x1. If I did this operation and I did that, I would get exactly the same solution. That is our choice. That is how we define it. Once we've defined it, we can now use it when we go to look for proofs. The same we're going to go if we look at the associative property. Let's put it up here, the associative property. So this associative type of binary operator. So our binary operator still is just going to be, this is our binary operator. Our set is still going to be our set of elements. And we call that set X. And now the elements that we're going to have is we're going to have 1, 2, and 3 elements. They are all elements of our set X. They are all elements. And we say now that this binary operation on these elements of the set is associative if the following holds. Again, as human beings, we decide this is our definition. Once we've defined it, we can use it, for instance, in a proof. And it is going to hold if the following is such, that if I take these two elements of X, any arbitrary elements of X, and I do the binary operation there, I do that first, and this result is then the X3, I get exactly this. That those would be exactly the same. So we have defined this under these circumstances, we have defined this as an associative type of binary operator and a commutative type of binary operator on elements of a certain set. That is how we define those.